born and 20 years ago. And he said to me, do I really want him to be honest? Give me an honest answer. Or do I want him to patronize me? I say it would be very disheartening if he patronizes me, but I would love for him to be honest and tell me honest truth. What do you think that about the Nigeria of before and Nigeria of today? And he told me very clearly, he said, Prince, that we have actually drifted backward. He told me that we are at the backward movement. And I said, why? He said two things. He doesn't want to say more than two. He said, am I safer now than 20 years ago? He said, Prince, he's much, much safer 20 years ago
than now.
He said, Prince, without security, can you develop a place? I said to him, he's 100% correct. So he went on and said, second thing, that development will elude you in the midst of war, in the midst of catastrophe, in the midst of chaos, in the midst of corruption. Development will elude you. Development, it will elude you. And that is what has happened to Nigeria. If you open Nigerian newspaper from the page one to page end, what you hear, 20 died in Jos, 30 died in
Kaduna,
15 harshly accident died in Owerri, 13 born to death in Benin, 80 in burning right now, breaking news, 80 people burning right now. The question is, how did we get to this? Because except and until we ask ourselves, how did we get to this situation? We're not going to make any headway. We should ask ourselves, how did we deteriorate to become a nation that is unsafe? The air is unsafe. The land is unsafe. The sea is the most unsafe. You know. So where is safety? Is it the air? Is it the sea? No, none of that. So how did we get to this? And meanwhile, these are the things that used to be safe for Nigeria. How did we, all of a sudden, Nigeria has entered into terrorist nation? 12, 15 years ago, Nigeria, if you say there is a terrorist in Nigeria, we will laugh at you. That's the word. We will laugh at you. If I come into United States of America, when I arrive in New York, 12 years ago, you know, they will only look at my documents. They will only search my documents and probably, you know, search my bag. But today, they search my documents, they search my body, they search my head, they search my ear, they search my nose. They may even ask you to go into the toilet.
Yes.
So you can give them some specimen. I want to tell parents, I've been in marriage now for 18 years, so I can still say that I'm still young in marriage, 18 and counting. I can tell to parents that they should not despair. They shouldn't, you know. Hope is still on the way. We cannot but love and love Nigeria. I have no
other country.
We don't have any other country. None that can be better than us. We know that it's a very, very
almost hopeless.
It's almost hopeless. But in the midst of the calamity, there are still a little bit of goodness coming forth. In the midst of bitterness, sweetness is going to come through. I am confident that Nigeria is going to come through these biggest challenges. It's very challenging, you know. You could see it, that the president, the commander in chief, Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, is doing his very best, but there is a lot more to do. You know, he knows it, and the good thing about him is admittance that more needed to be done. I'm only also going to use opportunity to tell him to make a more deeper search and get more proper people. You know, this is going to be teamwork. It's not going to be
just one man's effort.
The team he has is good, but he need to be reinforced continuously, and also make changes continuously. Changes also very inevitable. Make change even when someone is doing well, you can change, so that you can recreate,
yes.
You can be renovate. That's the Dubai that we are talking about. They are very creative. That everything good they cut from America, they paste. You see, Dubai saw the Mall of America.
Yes.
They went and did the Mall of Emirates.
Yeah.
And it's a fantastic place. You know, Dubai saw the Twin Tower in Chicago. They went and do Khalifa Towers in Dubai. It's a beauty to behold. And those are economic activities. You know, these things are something that is life-changing. And people can come all over the world just to go and see. You know, Nigeria is where tourism is gone. But it is going to be a madness to sell tourism when the people inside want to go out. You know, because tourism is not a push. Tourism is a pull. It's not a push. You do not market tourism. You make your place beautiful. You create paradise, and people hears about it. They want to come and see it. You don't go and be telling people, do you know what? I have a paradise in my place. You don't have to. People who will hear it when you have a paradise, and they will come naturally to go and see. They are going to be part of it and take pictures. So we need to renovate and create a beautiful Nigeria. So parents do not despair. Children, it's too thumb for children. Too thumb up. They own this country. This country is going to be better for them. But some of us are prepared to give everything that is required for it to be better. You know, at any level that is required of us. We are. I personally, we are going to engage the system. We are not going to stay aloof.
Yeah.
We are not going to stay back. We are going to participate. We are going to engage it. We believe that God is going to give us the grace, the strength, the character to push forward and continue to move forward.